All right, folks, greetings of peace. Welcome to episode 25 of my gameplay commentary of God of War, Ragnarok. This is yours truly, Bionic Hans and Francis Coleman. That is a now I consider that as a message to everyone here. However, this is still give me balance of story and challenge. So, and folks, this is still a trophy hunting gameplay.
Behind you, Ink!
Okay, maybe there's an ornier chest here somewhere. You know, God willing, with a good year lineup as I've announced in my YouTube channel, after this, Legend of Dragoon will be played and recorded for this YouTube channel, and it will be recorded in 1080 with 60 frames per second. I don't think there's a necessity for that to be 4K. Just like in the Suikoden Remastered 1 and 2, it will be recorded in 1080. While my prospective gameplay of Final Fantasy VII Remake Integrate and Horizon Forbidden West will be recorded in native 4K. And I hope that those gameplay and reviews will be oh, Asgardian Ingot, huh? Okay, one more Asgardian Ingot. Okay, as I was saying, hopefully those gameplay commentaries will lead to a better viewership for my YouTube channel, and better viewership on my YouTube channel, and you know, more subscribers. And you know, this year has been slow when it comes to trophy hunting, because I started this year with
I grow tired of your lack of empathy for your own wolves.
It's Deimos, isn't it, Mama?
I should not have told you, Deimos.
You see yourself in these wolves, in their fear.
Let us keep moving.
Shut up, Walt. Oh, you want to play it like that?
Alpha!
Kita.
Who captured the wolves before you freed them?
I do not know.
Regardless, they should draw some comfort from his death.
That was not an easy fight. But you know, slowly but surely. No, this is a reminder that Kratos and Freya were here. Aha. Wait. What now? What now? What now? What's going on?
Do not be afraid. You are safe. Good. Good boys.
Yes.
Good girls.
Who's Deimos? Who's Deimos again? More like the Assassin's Creed Odyssey version in this game, because in Assassin's Creed Odyssey you can mitigate the burn, the poison, etc. by rolling over. Alright.
Norns have any good news for you?
No.
Maybe buying something expensive will take your mind off it? Want something in particular?
Okay, one more.
Why are you just standing? Is it because I helped Atreus? Is this meant to scare me? Well, you should know. It's working.
Shut up, boy. Well, let's see. Well, in Midgard, I think these are just fetch quests.
Is that a frozen lightning bolt?
My fight with Thor ended there.
That's where you landed. No wonder there's bits of Tyr's statue all over the lake.
That must be Tyr's helmet from his statue.
That's Tyr?
Win minds, not wars.
Tyr understood the greatest fight of them all was the battle for people's hearts and minds. Too bad Tyr has no interest in doing either these days.
Yeah.
Tyr used to talk about how heavy the cost of war was compared to its bounties. He felt like it was his responsibility to avoid it.
Kind of still does, in fact.
I think I made a mistake here, folks. I have to go back to the Sindri.
To be a sculptor from the southern lands.
At your service. Where'd you find this? Midgard? Whatever you need. Hearts and the fury of the sky. Whatever you need, I'll create. I am, as always, at your service.
Alright, you know the purpose of that. My purpose is to just replenish Kratos' health and fury. What the heck is that?
Look, there's some debris over there. I'm guessing from Tyr's poor statue.
Defend the peace.
Well, I think that's the last of it. Doubtful we'll find any more interesting bits.
I always admired the love Tyr inspired.
Where I come from, gods of war are not revered in such a way.
Not all gods of war are the same, brother.
No, they are not.
I really don't like that attack. Alright, before I proceed to the gameplay, I'm just gonna have a little vendetta with this guy. I'll save those berserkers for last. On the other hand, during the previous gameplay, that spot right there, really gave me difficulties.
The Alpha!
Yep, sweet revenge. Alright, we're gonna push through with us to- Oh no, wait. I have to go to that Jotunheim. Or Vanaheim. There's this. There's this ghoul that I failed to kill during the first day in Vanaheim. Alfheim.
Tremble Winter had worn down some of Odin's curses, but you still needed help. Was it Sigrun who helped you recover your warrior spirit?
Is that how Odin liked to refer to the curse that kept me from defending myself?
Oh, I suppose that is where I heard it.
Would you like to know how that curse really worked? What it did to me? What it cost me to finally break it?
I'm no longer sure that I do.
That's correct.
Well, Sigrun must have helped find your Valkyrie wings. Were they hidden in the place I guessed?
They were not. But yes, she did. Argued all the while I should let my anger go. But help me just the same.
Where is Sigrun now?
Impossible to say. She's on a mission spanning the realms in search of our lost sisters. Our hope is if she can bring their incorporeal spirits to Vanaheim, we can find a way to restore them to uncorrupted forms.
You mean there's a chance for them to be back? Hopefully they're not fiends, because they are really difficult to deal with.
Certainly wasn't the same after that. At least for a while.
We'll just pick this up then.
Done exploring. We don't have the equipment for this.
There's gotta be a way to go back there. Well, it appears as of the moment that I can't go back there. So maybe some other time when we got some technology. Alright, I apologize folks for the delay and the
topic of prophecies brought about by the efforts to avoid them. I think I can recall such a story as you mentioned, brother. A Greek tale for the stage. Rather lurid, but very popular. You know the one?
Every Greek knows the tragedy of the Theban king.
Yeah, word gets around about that sort of thing.
Speaking of your brother after he was burned by the Aesir mob.
Yes. It haunted him for a long time. His carefree ways were replaced with nightmare. Paranoia and lashing out. It doesn't excuse what he said. My wedding. I do understand where his anger came from.
Maybe this is the way.
We don't have the equipment for this.
Alright, as you can see folks, episode 25 is coming to a close.
Something else I recall about that Greek play I mentioned, if you won't take offense to critique, as a work of performance that consisted almost entirely of watching people give speeches and receive terrible news, might have been nice to see more events dramatized instead of described.
It is Greek tradition for story to it. Single time and place uninterrupted. It is more clear.
If you say so.
Alright, it appears that there's nothing here as of the moment. We'll just return when we have all the available abilities to help us in the Okay, wait a tick. Alright, okay, just I apologize again, but before I proceed with the main story, I just want to...
There's something I've always wanted to ask. What was it Hringthor whispered to you?
Who?
Hringthor, the son of Thormur, the stonemason, who disguised himself and built Asgard's wall.
Oh, yes. One of the many occasions Odin saw fit to involve me in a wager without my consent. I wish I could say that was the worst of his husbandly habits.
What wager?
I've told this story, brother.
And now she may tell her own.
There isn't that much to tell. I knew nothing of it at first, surely because Odin didn't expect to lose the bet.
Not now.
And don't call him sure. And don't call Kratos surely. Alright, I'm gonna check if we can access a boat. In prayers, you know, headquarters. All right, starting episode 26, I'm going to move forward with the story. At least I had a well burst, and my confidence in Kratos' abilities have really doubled, if that is a correct statement. Let's see here. Alright folks, thank you everyone, God bless you all, and stay safe out there folks.